Welcome and thank you for joining our enterprise as you and hundreds of other Minnesotans scour Minnesota lakes in search of starry stonewort and other aquatic invasive species. I'm Megan Weber, an extension educator focusing on aquatic invasive species at the University of Minnesota, and we've created this video series to help orient you to the event and what to expect as you participate. Starry Trek was developed by us, the Aquatic Invasive Species Detectors Program team at the Minnesota Aquatic Invasive Species Research Center and University of Minnesota Extension, in partnership with the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources. We also worked with the River Alliance of Wisconsin and University of Wisconsin Extension as we developed this program. So if you know anyone in Wisconsin interested in participating, let them know that they can too. In Wisconsin, the event is called AIS Snapshot Day.
Hi, I'm Dan Larkin. I'm an associate professor and extension specialist at the University of Minnesota, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about the history of Starry Trek. We started this event in 2017 to help search for one of Minnesota's newest aquatic invaders, the algae starry stonewort. Starry stonewort had first been found in Minnesota in Lake Coronis in 2015. It is now known to occur in 14 Minnesota lakes. We know that early detection of aquatic invasive species gives us the best chance at effective management. And that's why events like Starry Trek are an important part of our toolbox. In fact, Starry Trek volunteers like you are responsible for discovering 3 of the 14 known populations of starry stonewort in Minnesota. That's over 20%.
I'm Pat Mulcahy, Program Coordinator with the AIS Detectors Program, and I want you to know how much of a difference volunteers like you can make. In 2017, Starry Trek volunteers found a few small fragments of what they thought might be starry stonewort in Grand Lake. Minnesota DNR confirmed the presence of starry stonewort in a small area near the boat launch in the lake following this report. Each year, starry stonewort is removed by hand from this area in a patch that grows smaller and smaller every year. So much so that in June 2020, divers were only able to recover less than a pound of starry stonewort from the lake during removal efforts. This response and successful control action was made possible thanks to the efforts of Starry Trek volunteers like you.
We also would not be able to host an event of this scale if it weren't for these organizations stepping up to host a local training site all over the state. So be sure to thank your local coordinator when you arrive to your local training site. Thanks again for joining the fleet. We hope you have fun and enjoy your day spent exploring nearby lakes while searching for starry stonewort. Be sure to check out the rest of the videos in the series to receive the rest of the training prior to your arrival at your local training site.